U.S. auto industry is in dire straits.
Reports showed manufacturing activity hitting a 26-year low last month.
Things happened real fast. Banks started falling into trouble. No one's going to buy a car in that kind of a climate. So I started seeing a layoff here, a layoff there. It just was a domino effect from there.
Automakers are desperately waiting for a lifeline while thousands of workers in all sorts of industries are losing their livelihoods.
If I don't go to work anymore, the five or six suppliers around us all go away. The gas stations all around here go away. The grocery stores close. In the span of less than a year, you know, a place like Lansing would be a ghost town.
Nobody knew what the future held. I was living from paycheck to paycheck, and that paycheck was an unemployment check from the state of Michigan.
We were on pins and needles watching every day, waiting. Please, please help us.
The nation's struggling automakers say that they need a loan to keep them from bankruptcy.
The president faces a staggering array of tough decisions.
It was a very, very unpopular thing to do at the time. Caught flak from all directions.
It'll come as no surprise that some Americans who've suffered the most during this recession have been those in the auto industry. We cannot and must not, and we will not, let our auto industry simply vanish.
I remember the day that President Obama came on TV and said that he was going to grant the auto loans. I sit up off the couch and was like, oh my God, we're getting our loans.
I'll never forget, my kids and I were all sitting here and we just hugged and I screamed and we all danced around like fools. So mommy's going back to work.
President Obama gave us the tools and we ran with it. So when we came back to work, we had a fire to do well, a fire to get it done, a fire to be a big company again.
Good evening. It worked. That's what the president said as he saluted the official return of America's auto industry.
We came back just with a vengeance.
Auto sales topped estimates in June.
As of tonight, General Motors is back on top.
What a proud moment for us. We came from the scariest moment in our life to the most triumphant.
The day that Chrysler paid back the loans, it was one of the proudest moments that I've had working at Chrysler because everybody worked together. From the CEOs down to the janitors to make our company survive.
We made a promise. Made a promise to the country, made a promise to the president, and we were gonna make good on it.
Don't bet against the American worker. Don't bet against the American people.
To me, a leader is someone that actually hears the people and is not afraid to work for the people. And I think President Obama proved that from what he's done for us.
He showed the kind of leadership and character that's required in a president that will do what's best for the group and not necessarily himself.
Since I've been back to work, I've seen new businesses sprout up all around the plant. So if we do good, everybody does good.
Are you better now than when you were 4 years ago? Yes, we are better. And we're going to be even better if we keep on going with what we've got going right now, and that's President Obama.